My dear friends, in Psalm 119, we see the situation that the psalmist was in. But the psalmist had a great trust in the Lord, and we'll see this right now. He said the following, My life is continually in my hand. That is, instead of leaving it in God's hands, he was holding on to it. Don't ever do something like that, folks. Yet I do not forget your law. Look, if the law of God says to give your life to God and he will sustain you, that you must serve him with all your soul, with all your heart and all your strength, then do it, folks. By putting your soul in the hand of God, Lord, my soul is yours. From now on, I am a divine possession. I belong to you. Then you can say, no, it's not in my hand. My soul is in the hands of God. And don't ever forget the law of God because it has commandments, and each commandment has a reward. You believe in the Lord God and he will save you. You trust in him that he will protect you. And so it will always be. Stop trying to hold on to your soul or you'll continue to be desperate. Or you'll remain in this seesaw that's not good. You have to abide in the rock that is Jesus. Take a look at a blessed person.
I couldn't do this with my
arm. You couldn't do that.
No, I couldn't.
You couldn't.
But now look.
Can you raise both your arms now? Oh, glory to God.
Oh, glory to
that's
God.
Great. Now let's say a prayer. Dear Father, I put my hands on the scriptures now because these people who feel they are in a seesaw right now might fall to one side or another, but Lord, this will not happen to them. I forbid the enemy from touching these lives, and I say to him now, get out, leave these people now, disappear now, in the name of Jesus Christ, and you can say amen, Father. Thank you.